What's going on, guys? It's your boy Scrub here, back again with another video. Hope you guys are all having an absolutely fantastic day. I know I am, and if you are, be sure to press the like button. Otherwise, no joke, no scam, you'll get cursed by the ghost of Christmas past. Yeah, that's right, guys, the ghost of Christmas past himself will come in and punch you in the back of the head unless you do the all very important job of pressing the like button. Anyways, guys, as you can tell from the title and thumbnail, today I've got a story about my neighbors. It's not really my neighbors, it's my parents' neighbors, but nonetheless, something ended up going down on Christmas night that, you know, might have spoiled Christmas just a little bit. But before we get into it, I am gonna be taking the Christmas merch down in a couple days, so if you haven't gotten it, consider it, and, yeah, that's enough self-plugging. Without further ado, let's get into it. So I decided to spend Christmas Day at my parents' house. We had some cousins in town from back around the Midwest, and I just really hadn't spent much time at my parents, so I decided that it would probably be best to spend all day over there. So, you know, we're hanging out doing our thing, and I grew up in this house with my parents for nearly 20 years, so throughout the day, certain neighbors, you know, are coming over and saying hi, because it's been a little bit since I've been there, and I went to school with a lot of their kids. I still know a lot of their kids. Me and the neighborhood kids that were home from college, you know, were hanging out. Like, it was just a chill day back in the house that I grew up in for Christmas. No big deal at all. But you see, the city that we live in grows really fast, so even though I hadn't really been at my parents' house, like, for a long time, in almost a year, there were still a couple new neighbors that not everybody knew very well. But because most of the neighborhood had been there for a long time and knew each other pretty well, it was just kind of this, like, weird feeling around this one house that wasn't partaking in any festivities. And like I said, I was going over to neighbors' houses where, you know, childhood friends lived and, you know, like, where people that I kind of grew up with were, so all day we're kind of talking, and I'm kind of asking about the family that moved out, and they're like, oh yeah, the new guys that moved in are super weird. And I was like, oh, what do you mean they're super weird? They're like, yeah, the new guys that moved in, there's like 8 dudes that live there, and they all drive motorcycles, and they like leave together as a group, and they come home together as a group, but they don't talk to anyone. Like, I guess my friend who still lives at home and like goes to college there was telling me and the other people that, you know, they drive motorcycles, and he's always liked motorcycles. So one day he walked up to him and like tried to have a conversation. They were like, oh, get lost, kid. Nobody get lost. Like, nobody cares what you have to say here. Get lost. He's like, okay. So, you know, 8 men, literally Snow White and the 8 dwarves, riding their motorcycles to work and back every day, live in this house and don't talk to anyone and have no association with anyone, which I thought was pretty weird, but I guess I just didn't really think anything of it. You know, some people are just weird, and that's the reality of the situation. I'm sure you're weird to somebody else. Like, listen, if you like Miracle Whip, you're weird. You might not think you're weird, but I'm promising you that you're a pretty strange individual. Regardless, Christmas is going on, and I'm not gonna lie, I do get a tiny bit hydrated from hanging out with my family and my friends and, you know, just overall having ourselves a good time. And, I'm hanging out with a couple of kids that I grew up with, and we're sitting in one of their living rooms, and we hear sirens start rolling down the road, right? Like, sirens. And, earlier we had heard a big boom, but we just assumed that, like, somebody had smacked the garage door with a basketball or something. It didn't sound like anything too crazy. So, we hear sirens rolling down the road, and obviously in a slightly hydrated state, I'm like, I wonder what's going on. And this is just a general piece of advice for all of you. If you hear sirens in front of your house, if you hear sirens near you, don't go investigate, because it's never gonna be good, you know, like, ever. When has there ever been a good time in a movie where police are outside of somebody's house? I'll give you an answer, never. They always walk in and go, your son was hacking Pokemon cards and selling them illegally and is now gonna spend 80 years in a federal penitentiary, you know? Like, it's never good, but whatever. We look outside and we are, you know, kind of looking for where these sirens are, and we see that they're up the street. So I put on my jacket. All my friends are like, okay, let's go see what it is. So we start walking over there, and as we're walking up, my parents come outside and they're wondering what's going on, and like other people's parents are coming outside and wondering what's going on. So almost as a collective group, we start walking down the street towards this house of people that nobody knows very well. And we get up, and it looks like something out of a movie on MTV in 2008, all right? I can't say the title, but at Bam Margera, Johnny Knoxville, like that group of people where they're doing a bunch of done stuff, because there's 8 dudes sprawled out with their hands on their head getting arrested by the police in various states of nudity, okay? Some of them, you know, got a Speedo thing going on. Some of them are wearing shorts. Some of them are closed. Some of them are wearing absolutely nothing, and they're all just kind of sitting there. And on the ground is the weirdest collection of items that I have ever seen, okay? I'm talking a hula hoop, a bunch of glow sticks, empty plastic bags, you know? Like, the ones you get from the grocery store. There's baseballs, half of a frozen turkey, just the weirdest group of items in the street. And we're like, what is going on? And one of the people who lived in this house, one of the eight dudes, who tends to be a little bit more on the nude side of things, is getting loaded into the back of an ambulance, and the police are talking to the person who lives next to them, right? So my dad and a couple of the other neighborhood dads go up and ask about what's going on, and they come back, and obviously I'm like, okay, what's going on? And he says basically this. Basically, these guys were not from here. They were all exchange students from a European country, right? And I guess they had decided that since, you know, Christmas is a time for family and they weren't going to be able to be with their family, that they were going to experiment with some stuff you get off the street and ingest, and that kind of alters your thinking, okay? Now, I would never, never advocate for doing any of this, but I guess whatever they decided to do is slightly known for starting hallucinations, you know, you kind of see things when you're on it. And when you're seeing things and you're on it, it's also possible for somebody to kind of tap into a mob mentality and make things get out of control very quickly, you know? And I guess that this group of guys had convinced themselves that the house they were in was going to explode because all of the gas that was being built up by them breathing too much. So they had decided to, like, stop breathing and spread out throughout the house and take off their clothes because I guess somehow in this massive explosion that they were irreversibly gonna cause, you know, being naked was the ultimate armor. Like, aha, we have matched you. You cannot blow us up, for we are naked. Aha. Whatever, and I guess they had eventually discovered in their hallucination that they could go outside, and they had gone outside, but I guess half of them were from the camp that they shouldn't go outside because that was gonna make the gases worse, so they started fighting the people that were trying to go outside to escape the gases. I don't know what the gases really had to do with this, but apparently this is what's gone on. So they were fighting in the street, and I guess completely unrelated, one of the families was going to leave to go to Christmas dinner at one of their grandmother's house and pulled out into the road, saw this, and when the guy tried to drive past them, they had decided to throw the turkey at him, and then they started running at the car. So the boom we had heard was them throwing a turkey at a car that was trying to drive by and then fighting in the street. So the guy had called everyone to figure out what was going on. The cops showed up, but these kids were on some substances that made them resistant to police interference, if you're picking up what I'm putting down, all right? Like, the fruit by the foot that they had eaten on Christmas morning would have made the police officers very jealous because it was red and blue. So I think that this is hilarious, and I'm laughing until I realize something that's not very good. I guess in the chaos of everybody coming out of their homes to figure out what was going on, nobody was really paying attention to the fact that all the little kids in the neighborhood, you know, my little cousins, my little brother, this entire group of younger kids had come out. And what do they see in the middle of the road on Christmas? You know, what's the magic of Christmas? Is it Kris Kringle flying away in his sleigh? No, it is a fully grown man in the nude with a frozen turkey and the rest of them getting loaded into the back of a police car. You know, like, it was just funny. So the guy whose car they had hit decided not to press criminal charges, figures they could probably just fix it after, you know, when they didn't have as many things inside of them. That's what she said. So all the little kids are obviously witnessing this, which makes me laugh even harder. You know, some people are mortified. What example is this setting? I think this is hilarious, bro, because imagine these kids are going to go back into school on Monday. All their classmates, you know, their teachers are going to be like, oh, what did you guys see over the Christmas break? Most kids, I saw snow. Santa Claus brought me a toy. This kid, yo, I saw eight dudes that dropped way too much of a certain substance and were absolutely delusional and throwing frozen turkeys at cars. Like, I'm sorry, that's just a way better experience for a kid to have, you know? That's a way better story when you grow up. Regardless, you know, I think it's hilarious, but the parents are dramatically upset. And there's this one older boomer on the street who usually isn't that bad, but, you know, I've had my fair share of trouble with just because I have a problem with authority. I'm not gonna lie and pretend that I don't, you know? I'm not gonna sit here and say, hey, kids, listen to the rules, because I always do. Listen to the rules because it makes your life easier. I'm telling you to listen to rules because it makes your life easier. But, you know, I know that because I never listen to rules and my life can be pretty difficult every now and then. So the boomer gets to the front of the pack, you know, and is like, you guys need to get your kids inside. Do you have any idea how inappropriate it is for children to be seeing this, you know? And I know the guy's name, and his name is, for the purpose of this story, I'll name him Richard, because his nickname should be Dick, you know? Like, I'll name him Richard. And Richard, you know, get your kids inside. This is highly inappropriate. And so I, out of instinct, because I am a little bit, you know, under the influence. I'm not gonna lie, I'd been a little bit hydrated. I go, ah, can it, Richard. So Richard starts screaming at me about how I don't even live in this neighborhood anymore, so I don't know why I think my opinion on this stuff matters, and, you know, I'm kind of just laughing at this point. And yes, it is bad that little kids did get to see this, okay? Don't get me twisted. I'm not celebrating the fact that a bunch of little kids had to see that. All I'm saying is, that's a pretty funny story, and one day they're gonna use it to make their boss laugh at work and get a promotion. But regardless, Richard starts screaming at everybody to go inside, so everybody starts slowly making their way inside. I start walking back to my parents' house, and as I'm walking, you know, Richard goes, Ryan, wait up! And I'm like, ah, crap. So I'm standing there, and he goes, do you think it's funny to disrespect me in front of the neighborhood? And I'm like, no, I'm sorry, you're right, it's not funny, yada, yada, yada. And he's like, that's what I thought. Merry Christmas, and walked off, and I was like, yeah, whatever, jerk off, shut up. So I go inside, and I'm kind of minding my business, talking to my mom now. I'm back home with my mom and dad. I'm no longer with my friends. And in the time between walking inside and starting to hang out with my cousin and my mom and my dad, probably 15 minutes go by, the phone rings, and sure enough, my mom walks out and walks back in with a disappointing look in my face, asking me why I was swearing in front of all the small children in the neighborhood, because an upset mother just called and said that I was. And if I did, that's my bad. But I'm about 95% sure that old hag Richard went out of his way to get me in trouble with my mom. And you know what? I'm an adult. I can swear in front of kids if I want to. But I would rather not have to argue with my mom about my choice to do so, okay? It was Christmas. You could have just let me have it. So yeah, moral of the story is, I don't know. There really isn't a moral of the story. I have no idea what I'm going to title this, because it's really a bunch of dudes that live in my old street got really high, did a bunch of dumb stuff, traumatized a bunch of children. I thought it was funny, laughed at it, and then my neighbor, who kind of has beef with me, texted my mom and said that I was making fun of it in front of children, and that I was probably being a bad influence, which got me in trouble and made my Christmas slightly less enjoyable. Yeah. That's the moral of the story, I guess. I hope that makes sense. Anyways, guys, hopefully you enjoyed it. If you did, be sure to press the like button. Let me know in the comment section down below what you thought. Today's notification shout-out goes to T-Man21. Big thank you for having on notifications. If you want a notification shout-out, turn them on. Send a screenshot to my Instagram, @Scrubby. And, yeah, on that note, have a beautiful day. Don't get anyone pregnant. If you do, make sure they're hot. I'll see you guys tomorrow with another video. I'm out. Peace.